What is up, guys? Today is another episode of Taylor Talks, the series in which I talk to you guys about what's on my mind. I pick a topic and I just kind of discuss it for 10 minutes. No scripts, no props, no B-roll, just me talking directly to the camera about a topic. And today's topic is going to be how to become a better developer and how you consistently have to strive for higher goals and how you achieve that. And so I've been a developer for quite a while now. I guess 2010 is probably when I officially started, so that's been 8 years now. So I'm definitely not an incredibly seasoned veteran, but I'm obviously not a novice. And so I always have to ask myself, how can I become better? How can I achieve more? How can I grow more as a developer? And primarily, the number one thing has got to be just trying new experiences, right? When I first started, my very first job was at a startup, and it was an incredibly crazy environment. It wasn't like a, oh, you know, you sit here and you do your thing, you work on this aspect of the startup. I was their first hire, so it was, hey, welcome to the job. You have to figure out our entire tech stack. You have to figure out the framework we're going to be using, the languages we're going to be using. You have to figure out literally everything about this, the database architecture, the front-end design, literally everything. Have fun. Good luck. And so it was really daunting, but it was also an incredible learning experience because when I was coming out of school, I knew how to make, you know, web apps kind of. I knew a few frameworks and I worked in PHP primarily. But then it was like, hey, here you are. And, you know, and then they would tell you the requirements. You know, there's going to be 10,000 users in the first month, 100,000 a few months later. These are our projections. These are the reasons why we're going to get there. So make sure the site can handle it. And that's kind of daunting, especially as my first job. I was kind of a little bit afraid, like, okay. But it was really cool because what ended up happening is I didn't get a lot of progress in the first probably 2 or 3 months, but I learned so much. It was ridiculous. I learned so much about database design and DevOps and just like actual design and backend programming. And I just learned, I would say I learned more in that 2 month window than I did the last 2 years of school. Like, it was insane how much information was crammed in there. And I think the reason that it worked so well is because I was not just working on backend. I was working on the front end and then the backend. And then, oh, I need to adjust the API. Oh, never mind, this is a database architecture issue. Oh no, I have to update this, that, I have to do some DevOps today. And it was a really nice, wholesome experience where I learned all the different aspects, and it really helped better inform me on how things were really working and where they were happening. And so when an issue would happen, I wasn't like, oh, that's a, you know, I wasn't like, oh, I wonder how that bug happens. I knew immediately. I was like, oh, that's a front end issue with this rendering in the blade view or something. It was like, I knew exactly what it was because I had worked on all the different components. Excuse me. And so that was incredibly useful. But then after a while, you know, the platform went up, everything went fine. I learned and I learned and I learned. But eventually at the same job, you just kind of, things get stagnant. You don't really learn as much. You know your framework, you know your architecture. It's more of a maintenance mode and you add new features here and there, but it's really not challenging. And so I wanted to be a better developer, and I knew that the time in which I learned the most was when I was learning new things, and I knew that I had to do that. So I actually left that job and found a different job working in a completely different tech stack. It was a completely different world for me. I didn't know anything about it, and that's when I started getting into Node, React, and kind of these progressive web apps that you're seeing nowadays that are primarily based in JavaScript. And so while I was doing that, I also was like, no, this isn't enough. I need to learn even more. And so I also made mobile apps on the side. I made Android and iOS applications in a framework called Ionic, which uses Angular under the covers. So I kind of switched my entire paradigm overnight. I was like, all right, I'm leaving this job that I use PHP and Laravel and kind of do things in a typical LAMP stack that has been done for years and years and years. And I'm switching to this completely different framework where everything's done in JavaScript, and I'm using, you know, I'm making stuff for iOS and Android and the web in this totally different way. And it was very much a similar experience. I learned so much more than I ever would have if I stayed at that same job. And not just like, oh, I learned a new language, so therefore I learned more information. No, I'm talking, I became a better developer. I understood design paradigms a lot better. And I just, you just become a better developer overall, the more and more different aspects of software that you learn. It's not just learning a new language every week, because you can do that if you really want, and But eventually that becomes kind of easy too, you know what I mean? You get really used to switching between language contexts. Like right now, my current job, I do C++, I write in PHP, I write in JavaScript and Node, I do CSS and HTML as well. And you just get used to it. You just get used to context switching between all the different languages and learning all the different syntax and how easily you can switch. And what you gain as the aggregate of doing all of that and learning all of these different aspects of software design is that you understand more holistically what's happening at every stage. And so you don't, when you make decisions like, oh, should I do a for loop here, or should I just do, you know, what I need to on chunk A and chunk B, and you're like, well, this, in this situation, just doing, you know, functional programming block A and B is going to work really great, but really this should be something that's extensible, because you know, as someone who's worked in database administration, that type of stuff might change. You might change how you're doing the back end. It might no longer be a MySQL database. It might switch to a MongoDB. And so as a developer, when you're making the backend API, you might think, oh, I need to make this extensible. I need to make it so that I can switch between MySQL or Mongo at any point without having to refactor all of my code. And so just being in different environments, learning constantly, and switching between something that you're familiar with to something totally new all the time is incredibly useful. So I would say if you can't switch jobs, and I'm not saying to just quit your job and get something new. That worked for me because I had a lot of options at the time, and I just wanted to do something different. I wanted to learn something different, but learn side projects. At the same time, while doing all of this, I learned C# and game development with Unity, and I dabbled in Unreal a little bit with C++. And so you can do any side project you want, but it's just important to branch out. And it's really hard because if you're really familiar with your stack, like if you love, say for instance, Laravel, like let's say you love Laravel and PHP and MySQL and you understand everything about Apache and you just have no issues whatsoever. Someone says make a website, you can make it, that's great. But the problem is that over time, tools become outdated, methodologies become outdated, and there's new, better stuff that gives you more benefit for less time. And if you are just someone who sticks to the same thing year after year after year after year, you're gonna get left behind and you're never gonna become a better developer. Yeah, you might be the world's best Laravel developer, but one day someone might, you know, stop working on Laravel. It might not be supported anymore. Someone might get rid of it. I would say in 10 years, PHP is going to be a very close to dead language, which is insane to think about, but I think it's going to happen. And so it's hard because you can never learn one language and be foolproof for the rest of your career. And so my advice is, instead of doing that, don't at all do the exact opposite. Learn as many languages as you can, learn as many paradigms as you can, learn everything about every aspect of programming, even if you think you'll never use it. You'll be amazed at how often front end interacts with back end, and your decisions on the back end will affect changes on the front end. And if you know how it works on the front end, it completely changes your mindset when you're developing in the back end. So, long story short, just learn as much as you can. That's the number one way to become a better developer. There's no magic sauce. You know, it's not like you should debug more, or you should do X more, or you should, you know, there's no magic bullet that you can just do and just become a better developer. In my opinion, the only way to do it truly is to be in code as much as you can in as many different ways as possible. Anyways, if you guys liked the video, hit that subscribe button, and if you have any suggestions for a future video or another topic for a Taylor Talk, let me know. Anyways, later guys.